everybody, it's Nikki here. 안녕하세요. 저는 Nikki입니다. Today, we are going to be talking a little bit about defamation laws in Korea. As you may have seen on a lot of Korean news sites, a lot of agencies are starting to go against malicious comments and anything that falls under defamation. Now in the US, it's freedom of speech, I believe, still, where you can say whatever you want to somebody in a certain extent. Now in Korea, it's completely different. If you say true statements, but that can still kind of hurt the person you said it about and made it with full intent to hurt them, there's a law that they can come after you for that. If you say false things just to hurt somebody, they can come after you for that. Now, even if you spill facts about them that they didn't want to come out to the public, they can come after you for that. Now, I don't know to the extent to whether or not that can be set against worldwide people that comment or say things like that, or if that's just stuck in Korea. Which I'm pretty sure it's just within Korea. However, maybe if you're one of those people, because I know there's a ton of people out there that just say whatever comes to mind about idols, go on a diet, which I think is insanely rude, or just go on a slander match, which I've seen on Twitter before, where it's again a fandom war thing, where one fandom goes after another fandom and tries to find the most nastiest thing out about whoever they're having their beef with. And they could come after you for that, especially if you're in Korea. So there's a lot of comments and a lot of angry fans a lot of times, even especially K-Nets, who go on and then will comment mean things on Twitter, on YouTube, IG, any SNS. And now agencies are cracking down to go after them. Like YG has been going on about that more and more. They're going forward with claims as well for someone who leaked information. That's also another thing. You should never leak information because they will come after you legally. Like, what's wrong with you? You shouldn't do that. But Big Hit has been a very big one, especially with BTS being as big as they are now. While they're gaining fans, they're also gaining haters. And not all haters are quiet and sit in their corner and just grumble to themselves. A lot of those haters go out and make sure that everybody in BTS knows how much they hate them and say all these vile, nasty things. Now, Big Hit can go on and find out who these people are and then sue them. And with the defamation law, they can even, to an extent of the ruling, they can be imprisoned to up to 7 years for defamation. Now, that's a big chunk of time. What I'm getting at is, yes, we are the world, we have the World Wide Web, we have freedom of speech, we can say whatever we want. When it comes to idols, we can't forget that they're also people. They're called idols, but these idols are people. They have a facade. Not saying that they're fake people, no, they're not. They're very true people with very much a lot of feelings. But you also have to look past that word idol and see the person who is that idol. And I've come to find out more and more what people just easily say, even within a fandom, nasty things about another member. And nobody seems to think back and see that that can hurt them. Do you have to like everybody? No, you don't have to like all these people in the world. But you don't have to go out of your way to make sure that they know how much you hate them. There's real people behind idols. There's real people. Real people who get exhausted, who want to just be alone, who are tired, who just want to have fun on their own time, who just want to be. And I think respect goes a long way. And with K-pop becoming so global now, we seem to lose more and more of the respect and see idols as just dolls, puppets, people ripped out of a manga, instead of actually seeing the person that stands behind that idol. There's so many pictures that are being posted from airports that I hate so, so much, where you can see the pure exhaustion on their face, on the idol's face, especially the ones that are on tour now. And everyone's like, oh, look how handsome, look how happy. And I'm just sitting here, I don't know, I can read people pretty well. I can read between the lines very, very well. And all I'm seeing is pure exhaustion in their eyes. If you followed K-pop for a long time and followed a group for a very long time, you can kind of see the way idols are and how they look like when they're happy and when they're just being themselves. And then you can see when they're saying they're happy, but their face speaks something else. And coming back to Defamation, with the globalization of K-pop, we will see more and more hate coming their way. And I know it's a big thing here in the US where we will have to listen to all these people that don't understand K-pop and how much they hate it. But in Korea as well, they will continue, new groups will come and they will hate on these new groups. I know TXT is having a hard time because so many people are saying they're just riding on the clout that BTS created. But it's Big Hit who created TXT. So I think we all should just take a step back and maybe think to ourselves that yes, those are people. They are training a very long time, many, many years. They are people. If you don't tell your neighbor how much you hate them on a daily basis, you shouldn't do that just because the internet protects you in a way and doesn't show your face. Because in reality, you can always find out who is behind the username. There are ways to do it, especially for someone who is going after you for defamation. There are court orders that can be put in place to find out who you are behind that username. And all in all, I just want people to be more aware of while you are anonymous on the internet, you are only anonymous to a certain extent. If there's any other topics you would like me to talk about, feel free to leave a comment down below. I don't mind digging through folders and offices and whatnot, which is all on the internet now. No one has to do that. No one has to be like an agent with flashlights and okay, I'm creating a whole different image in my head. But yes, feel free to leave a comment down below. I will do my thorough research for you. Don't forget to follow all my social media, Instagram, Twitter, and my website, HallyuHeaven.com. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click the little bell icon so you can get notified when I upload new videos. I love you guys. 사랑해. Bye-bye. 안녕.